world. There are a lot of things. The Ministry of Finance work hard trying to protect, you know, make sure you have enough savings and so on. I don't want to hazard a guess. When I was a student, my bill, my credit card bill was fairly high. I don't know what your credit card bills look like. Could be fairly high as well. It was fairly high. I don't know how I did it. I mean, you know, so I was quite surprised to see my final bill when I left England. It was like, oh, so, you know. And I wasn't even in England. But it was quite high. And it's quite easy to get into debt without much problem. Housing. No matter how many houses we build, there will never be enough. People keep applying for houses. And I'll tell you why. This one is especially a dilemma. And there are issues with defense, security, environment, and managing rights expectation. And the foremost thing, which I think is one we're facing, is welfareism mentality. What was the first thing your father did, or your grandfather did, all those days ago? First thing they do was to secure a house. They buy land. And what's the first thing we do? Buy a car. We don't buy land because we know our father had land. You know? But the expectation is changing. Or even if you don't buy land, you don't have to worry. The government's going to give me a piece of land. So you don't worry about it. So this is worrying because everybody expected. But then we can't provide those things. Houses need areas. And I'll tell you why in a minute. So, you know, and of course there's money and things involved. There are certain things which, like I said, some short-term conditions we have. I told you earlier about the maritime water issue. Hopefully they will take care of our oil and gas. The new methanol plant should be functioning very soon, you know, for the Pulang Besar project. And alhamdulillah, the Ministry of Finance, all those surpluses I was talking about, we didn't spend it. We kept it under the sustainability fund. So we actually have two funds at the moment. One fund kept by the BIA and one fund kept by Treasury under the sustainability fund. So we've learned our lessons from the crisis in 1997. So we've learned that lesson as well. And alhamdulillah, the way I see it, it happened, oh, okay, all right. I got, oh my God. 5 minutes, I got 5 minutes left, and I've got about 70 slides, by the way. This is not okay. I will mention the rest, but basically there are the NGOs and so on. So now, this is a problem in the script. Okay. I was going to talk about the Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Development, but forget it. I think we can do this on the website. We are on Facebook, by the way. We are doing a mystery in Brunei, which is on Facebook. So, you know, come. We do get critics and everything, but you know, it works. You know, it doesn't matter. To me, as long as I get the message out, it works. So, you know, this is our vision again, more or less the same things, our mission. So we'll not talk about this are the less important things, but they're important, but at the moment, I think in 5 minutes, they're not so important anymore. Jeez, I think there are so many things I cannot talk about. Okay, this is our strategy. These things are the ones that I will focus on. These are the six things that I will focus on in this journey. And I'll tell you what. Goes the other way now. I'm searching for a keyboard here. All right, it's a mouse.
Keyboard isn't it?
Okay, all right, here we go. All right, okay. Now, first thing first. We're not big. That's the first thing you have to remember. 5,766 square kilometer is a very small size. It's about the size of Lincolnshire. I checked this morning. If we were to put the list of all the English counties, we will rank 6. Which is not so bad. But then there are 90 counties. So we are nothing. Even in the English scale, we are nothing. Do you remember, you watch TV, right? You always talk, you always, do you know, do you realize Palestine gaza strip in the West Bank. They look like kind of tiny. They look squashed by, you know, their next door friend. But that Palestinian, the West Bank and the Gaza Strip is actually bigger than us. That we have to remember, we are small. And if you think the Palestine country has small, we are smaller. So that's the most thing that you remember. Big, small. It's a lot of things you have to worry about. This is the land availability study we did in 2005. After taking into account the Hardaponio initiative, all the things we've already kept aside for the land, all the land owned by people, all the things we kept aside for all the infrastructure, we found out what this bit left. 5% of Brunei is left unconstrained. 5%. And that is you to worry about, your children, your grandchildren, what are they going to do? So we have to start thinking. It's a choice. I mean, you know, we can always cut down the trees. Is it an option eventually? These little areas here, these are one of the only things that you can actually do things about. The rest of it is, forget it, you know. We can do something else. Not much left for Brunei. Okay. Now, under land use, there are many things we have to worry about. Making land use. Present and future needs, our size is going to remain 5,766 square kilometers. 1 minute, I know, all right. And basically, these are all the things we need to do. Not much. Many things we need to do. And then we've got 5% left for Brunei. And under the land use master plan, we've planned it. Basically, we're going to build what we call a bipolar system. We're going to concentrate on Brunei Muara as one polar and the Sumerian district as one polar. But it's not important. But basically, we have something in line. And again, there is highways and things which we have to build. This is bringing Brunei to about 2035. Okay? Now, environment. We don't produce that much. I think we only produce about 8.8 metric tons. But that makes us sixth in the world in terms of per capita. We are a big emitter. Alright? And this is what we do. We consume 450 liters of water per person per day. You know how much 450 liters of water is? It's a lot. Okay, it's okay. I'll go on. It's a lot of water. We are probably one of the cleanest people in Asia. Japanese don't use this much water. We throw away 1.4 kilograms of waste every day, each one of us. So, you know, and there's a lot of things that to get all these things up and running, not in the hand can say, you know, we're building dams, we're building things, just to bring the water supply up to capacity. But we can't keep doing that. Dam cost areas. Each dam can take up to 500 hectares. You know how much the hectare is about 2 acres. This is 1,200 acres per dam. If you go to the old airport government complex, that's 50 acres. So imagine 1,200 acres, how many of government complex areas that we have. Waste, landfill. You know, I don't want to talk about Sungai Angkat, but there are many things that you want to talk about. You haven't been to Bukit Duvel. You haven't been to Aduki, you know. But of course they're a lot better. But the thing about waste is that you only pay for the collection. You don't even pay for the disposal. If you give incinerators, you still pay for the incinerator. Houses.